If you wanted to build or produce most anything, I want to think a little bit about what you would need to do it. And I have some pictures here just to get our imagination going. These guys are up to making something with iron, or maybe making iron bars, or making some type of a thing out of iron. And right here is an old picture of some planes being made in a factory. But let's just think in very general terms, the things you need to produce anything. So first of all, you're going to need some land. And that's definitely true if you're running a farm or if you're trying to produce timber. But you definitely need land even if you have a factory. Obviously, both of these factories are sitting on top of some land. Then you're going to need a building, maybe, but most probably a building. You're going to need some tools and equipment. Tools and equipment. Then you might need some raw materials. In this case, it might be iron over here, too. You would need some metal. You might need some electricity or some oil to keep the production lines going. So you're going to need some raw materials. Raw materials. And then you're going to need people to actually work in your factory. And this guy, you know, these guys putting these hot bars of iron inside of whatever this thing right over here is, or the people working on the factory line. You don't see them here. This must be off time. But you need people to actually work on the factory line to tighten bolts and all the rest of things. So you're going to need labor. You are going to need labor. And if you put all of these things together, if you put all of these things together, then you should be able to produce your product. So you'll be able to output whatever you set yourself to do. So in the classical sense, when you think about all of these different things that you might put into production, sometimes they're referred to as the factors of production, they separate out, and this is in the classical sense, they separate out building and the tools and equipment as one of the classes. So you have land, you have labor, and you have buildings, and sometimes, just to throw it in there, sometimes you'll throw in management or organization in here. Someone needs to figure out how to lay out all of this type of thing. So this could also be a factor of production. But buildings and tools and equipment, they're kind of separated out from everything else. And in the classical sense, they're referred to as capital. They are referred to as capital. And they kind of have this separate distinction because these are things that are made by human beings for the specific purpose of producing other things. So obviously, there are other things that are made by human beings. For example, let me think of something that's nicely. So a hat. A hat is clearly made by a human being. But it's not made to, it's not produced to produce other things. It's meant for fashion. It's meant to kind of improve someone's quality of life. But it's not made to make other things. In this case, the building and the tools, the whole reason why they were made is to make other things. And so in the classical sense, they are referred to as capital. Now, if we go to kind of more modern times, you'll hear words like human capital. Human capital. Or financial capital. And you'll see a lot of different types of capitals that people try to talk about. Human capital or financial capital. So what are they talking about? Because as in the classical sense, capital were things that people made so that those things can help us make other things. So the analogy is human capital isn't just straight up labor. It plays a role in it, but when in modern times, when people talk about human capital, they're trying to make the same analogy. They're kind of investments made in humans so that those humans are better at producing other things. So human capital, when people refer to it, they're things like education, skills, talents that someone might have, talents, experience that someone might have inside of them or that were invested in them, if you think about the situation of education, that make them more productive. So they're things that are thrown into a human being that make them able to produce more output. So this is what people refer to as human capital and how it's different than just straight up labor. Labor is just, look, any human being can go there and move something from one place to another or pick something up and put it on a shelf or take it off of a shelf and put it on another shelf. But what human capital is are the investments in that person that make them more productive, more skilled, more able to do more interesting things. things. The same thing is true, just to throw it in there, just so you can kind of see this analogy, is financial capital. You could just say, look, there's something like, you know, there's money for money's sake, or there's, you know, that you could use to buy a hat, or that you could use to buy really almost any of these other things. But when people talk about financial capital, they're talking about money that's being used for the purpose of producing more output. So you could view it as the money that you actually need to run a factory, that you could you know, for example, they'll call it working capital. It's the money in the cash registers that you can actually run your store, or run your restaurant. Or it could be money that's put to work by buying kind of traditional capital for buying these capital goods so that you can produce more output. But the whole idea here, I just want to introduce you to the idea of capital. It's central to the word capitalism in its classical sense, and then maybe in the more modern sense, especially when people talk about something like human capital.